Hey, so Rob, I got this simple wire form that I need to...
There's a lot of simple things when it comes to you and I.
But I need to get this quoted. And so
you do?
I'm thinking I'm going to just send it out to three manufacturers, three suppliers of wire forms. It's a simple part, right?
People say that, but there's no such thing as a simple part.
Explain.
So you could choose the process and end up with a part that costs the least amount of money and it doesn't actually work and it breaks and it costs the company to bring in and repair the product all the time, when maybe one more penny, that part would work a lot better.
You know, that's a very good point, and that leads us to today's guest on Ask a Guru. So here's a company that does the simplest things to save you big money, and that's why this company is really special. So
Dan, introduce yourself to our Part Gurus podcast watchers.
Hello, I'm Dan Miller, owner of Crawford Manufacturing. We do wire forms, metal stampings, and assemblies.
You know, they make wire forms and stampings, but that's a really broad category. These gurus specialize in long-run simple parts like the one I need made. So Dan, like, what's your capabilities? Can you handle this?
We can do up to quarter inch in diameter and feed lengths of 26 inches. Low end, 10,000 per run, like to go up into the hundreds of thousands, possibly millions, depending on the parts.
So, Dan, how did you start the business?
My father started the business because of his frustration with quality. And he started making product on his own because he couldn't buy a good enough product, and that's how we got into the metal stamping business. We have lower tonnage, up to about 40 tons, and we have the high-speed Bruder stamping press. We can do up to 500 strokes a minute.
Hey, Dan, show us a sample or an example of a high-speed stamping part.
This is a high-speed stamping made out of copper. We can manufacture that at 400 strokes a minute.
So a lot of your parts seem simple. You just need a print and a simple quote, right?
You know, I prefer people coming to me and asking questions. What can you do to make this easier? We found that we've been very successful in helping customers make a part more manufacturable by them consulting us a little bit ahead of time.
Ah, Batman. It's called DFM, Design for Manufacturing. That makes sense.
You know, I also hear that as Design for Manufacturability, which actually is even maybe more descriptive of what it does. Is it possible to make this part?
I agree with you, especially with
it manufacturable?
Right.
One example of us helping in development is this particular product here. It is used in the gaming industry. It had some special forming on it that one of my competitors had reneged on the project, said they can't do it because the blades have to lay down on the side. So we picked it up and saved the customer. It was a difficult project.
So Dan, what you're basically describing is a problem that needs to be solved, not just get a quote or a part to be made.
Give us an example of helping to develop a part for a client.
Here we were able to add value to the customer because we were able to put this ball on the end, a little bit of cold heading, but it's done in a slide forming machine. This is for a dishwasher basket, so they needed that so the wire so it dries better. The nylon coating that goes on this part cannot have any leaks in it because it's a dishwasher basket. Need to kill the sharp edge around that, which we do. It's also kind of a cold heading operation. In the process of making the part, saves a lot of money. We eliminated the secondary.
I see what he's saying. So what happens is, if this was a dishwasher part and they got a sharp edge right here, when they coat it and then somebody puts the glass on it,
breaks right away.
It breaks off, and then the coating breaks off, not the part.
Right.
And then what happens is the customer complains, the dishwasher manufacturer has to go and field service it or get replacement parts. So why not spend the extra penny up front and cold head the part? What a brilliant move.
It's not the cheapest part. It's not the most expensive part. It's the right part that you need.
That's the key, the right part.
You know why my dishwasher doesn't break?
Why? Because you never use it.
No, my hands never break.
No, because her name's Annie.
These are called bridle rings. They're used in the electrical cabling industry, stringing cables throughout buildings. We make millions of those. This is something that we kind of do on the side. It's called an ache beater. You can't buy these made in high volume anymore, but we make the lower end of it, which you see the components of here.
Since you stamp, do you also draw parts?
You mean like on a sketch pad?
Dan, do you draw parts?
This is a little bit of drawing, but it's also used in the egg beater as a bearing, basically. Here's a small little clip. This little clip here is a shield for a wire on a terminal block. And one thing that we were able to help the customer with on this part was they were making it out of spring steel and then heat treating it and plating it, thinking they're saving money. So we suggested using stainless steel because it's got the corrosion resistance and the spring properties, and we've been making these in the millions for about a decade and a half now.
That part that you were drawing looks like a part that I used when I put my deck together. You know those little clips that go in between the boards?
Yeah.
Is that what it is?
This is one of our newer ones here for the construction industry, used in decking. Goes into a biscuit like this, but we do that particular part at 300 strokes a minute. This might be a little bit of interest. This goes on the collar of a workhorse. Holds the sweat pad in place underneath the collar of a workhorse.
Just like with anything, tooling is required, but...
I mean, can you cut corners on tooling?
You cannot make cheap tooling and get good product. We have a full tooling facility, including wire EDM. We service our own tools, we design our own tools, build our own tools. If there's a breakdown, we fix our own tools. All of that is in-house.
What a great story. I'm glad we talked to this guru. So, Dan, what do you say to someone who is thinking about switching suppliers or finding a new supplier?
So for your wire forming needs, I'm Dan Miller. It's Miller time. Thank you.
More and more of these situations where we have these experts on, these gurus, we get to little nuggets of information that helps you out there source better. And that's why we invite you to like and subscribe to our channel to keep watching these great little clips where we are the idiots who bring on the experts and bring you Ask a Guru.
Ask a Guru. And you don't know what you don't know, and we don't know a lot, so you know a lot if you watch us knowing what you know.